This red ear slider has not been able to poop for a week. Usually, red ear sliders poop and eat every day. The owner is very concerned, so he brought it here to the Toa vet for help. This x-ray shows that the stomach is impacted with stools, and a physical examination shows that the terrapin is very thin. By day 5 of treatment, it is still not able to poop and is not eating. What can the vet do? This is a Be Kind to Pets veterinary educational video sponsored by Toa Payoh Vets.
September 8, 2018.
Okay. This is a red ear slider, female, about 12 years old. Now, you can see this is a very unusual color. Normally it's dark green, but this one seems to be bronze. And what's it called? When you had it, has it got this color before? When you had this?
It was darker.
Huh? No, this is a very unusual golden color. So far I've seen hundreds, but I haven't seen one which is fully golden. So I don't know. It wasn't born like this?
No, it wasn't. It was darker.
Darker or green?
Dark green.
So it changed color recently?
Not recently. Hmm?
Because sometimes the change of color is indicative of some disease, systemic disease. Like human being, when the skin is jaundiced or yellow, it changes. I mean, it's not a normal skin color. This is not a normal color. Okay, but what's the complaint now? It's not eating.
It's not eating, and when I put it in the pool, the tank, it's trying to desperately swim up the surface.
Okay. When was that?
A few days ago.
Few days ago,
yeah.
And didn't pull already.
Didn't pull already. But when I feed it, it has to be inside the water basin.
Correct. So when you feed the pellets, what happened? It finished off?
It finished off.
Very fast?
Very fast, yes. But when I try to feed it lettuce, it's not very enthusiastic. It eats, but not enthusiastic.
Before that?
Before that, okay. Never tried.
Oh, never tried, then of course it's not enthusiastic. It's not used to it.
Yeah.
But the pellets, you feed 10 to 15, right?
Yeah.
Every day.
Once every day, every night at most.
Yeah, but I mean for the past years.
Yes.
You count them? I mean, you really count the pellets?
I actually just pour.
One tablespoon or you pour?
I just pour from the container.
Okay. Now, according to the owner, it's based on the volume of the head, but actually, they are talking about the volume of the head, so the amount is based on the volume of the head.
Mostly, yeah.
That's why you guess.
Estimate, just a guess.
Okay. So, you can see that this is very thin, basically no fat here, you see that? Zero fat, so it must be underfeeding. You could have underfed a lot, underfeeding. Or it's sick. Now, normally it's quite fleshy, like you say. But you see, basically no more flesh, no more fat also. But other than that, is it very active?
In the past, yes, no reason.
No, doesn't work. Don't move at all?
You mean recently or in the past?
No, recently.
Recently doesn't.
Does it stay still? Does stay stationary?
It shifts its body direction but doesn't move a lot.
How about swimming? Does it swim?
In the past, yes. Recently, no.
September 2018.
Sunday. Today is day 2 of inpatient for this red ear slider, female, 12 years old. The complaint is that although she's eating, she will always swim up to the surface when put inside the tank of water. Okay, now I weigh first. Okay, we weigh first. This is day 2 of treatment of inpatient. What's the weight?
970 grams.
So yesterday, what was the weight?
940.
So you gained a weight of 10-30 grams, right? Turn upside down, I released the obstruction there. There was an obstruction point to the vent. Is there any more swelling?
No swelling.
No more swelling. Wait, let me just video. Yeah, no more. So there's no more obstruction. There was a ball of stools obstructing. Okay, now we put this onto the water there. Put in the center. Okay, yes, eaten 5 pellets, right?
Yeah.
5 or 10 pellets. Okay, we just put 2 there and see. You can see that this she has appetite, but she's very skinny. She's like bones, all bones. She's fed many pellets. She has a very big tank at home, and when the owner put her into the water, she will swim up very fast, trying to avoid being submerged. Now, okay, we pour water now. Just close the container. Don't open up the container. Close the container. We don't always open up the container. Okay, then. Okay, now we pour water. Take away this one first. Take away this one. Just pour the whole pail in here. Slowly. Let me see. Is he swimming lopsided? Or is there any problem? See what the owner say is true or not. In the meantime, keep the things ready. Keep that one. No, keep the weighing machine. Don't spoil. I thought you spoil it really bad. Well, what owner said didn't happen here. She's quite happy to be submerged in. We put in the center. She doesn't want to swim, yeah. But she didn't surface very fast like what the owner said. Only thing, she doesn't move because she's very skinny, emaciated. Now I'm going to see the x-rays. Already open the door. Put her out first. Take her out first on the floor first, yeah, in case she can't, she get drowned. Okay, put it here first, okay. Okay, let's see the x-ray. Come open the door. Okay, now this is the first x-ray done yesterday. Now I can see there's some impacted stomach and duodenum. This may account for the fact that what the owner says is true, constipation. The stools are here in the vent. You see the first video, they have been removed. They are not hard stools, but they are soft stool, so normally the stomach is on the left hand side. Stomach got a lot of folds normally. Yeah. Now this could be the whole thing could be stomach as well. And the duodenum is the small intestine. So it seems that the stomach is impacted, means full of something inside, so it didn't move. Somebody didn't move, so the red ear slider is very thin because probably it didn't absorb any nutrients. Now we look at the side view, lateral view. Now lateral view is clearer. There's definitely, this is normally the stomach distended, no? With probably food. So this is why the red ear slider doesn't want to move when submerged in the water. So now let's go and see how is she now. Open the door, come. Let's go and see her one more time. We have to give oil laxative. Oil laxative to move the stomach. Yeah. Put it on the floor here, so move or not. I'm not worried. You think you'll run away? I don't think so. Only thing good is she's eating. Okay, 30 pellets yesterday?
Yeah.
30 pellets. Come, let's show the pellets. We are feeding this, which is the owner put there, no? For me to see, no, the container. Neutrophil. Okay, so now we will put her back. And is there any stools here? Let me see.
No.
Hmm?
No stool.
How about the black thing? No, nothing. Okay, put her back inside here again. Maybe I think what the owner said was she doesn't want to come to the surface. But the owner, because we have to confirm the owner, it just doesn't move. If it doesn't move too long, then you can't breathe. Okay, we'll give a little water and then we feed with the water, with the pellets again, below the neck level, and give oil laxative and antibiotics. X-ray done yesterday. Now I can see there's some impacted stomach and duodenum. And this may account for the fact that what the owner says is true, constipation. The stools are here in the vent. You see the first video, and they have been removed. They are not hard stools, but they are soft stools. So normally the stomach is on the left hand side. The stomach on the left hand side. Stomach got a lot of folds normally. Yeah. Now the whole thing could be stomach as well. And the duodenum is the small intestine. So it seems that the stomach is impacted, means full of something inside, so it didn't move. Stomach didn't move, so the red ear slider is very thin because probably it didn't absorb any nutrients. Now we look at the side view, lateral view. Now lateral view is clearer. There's definitely, this is normally the stomach distended, no? With probably food. And so this is why the red ear slider doesn't want to move when submerged in the water. So now let's go and see how is she now. Open the door, come. Let's go and see her one more time. We have to give oil laxative. Oil laxative to move the stomach. Yeah. No, put it on the floor here, so move or not. I'm not worried. You think you'll run away? I don't think so. Only thing good is she's eating. Okay, 30 pellets yesterday?
Yeah.
30 pellets. Come, let's show the pellets. We are feeding this, which is the owner put there, no? For me to see, no? The container. Neutrophil. Okay, so now we will put her back. And is there any stools here? Let me see.
No.
Hmm?
No stool.
How about the black thing? No, nothing. Okay, put her back inside here again. Maybe I think what the owner said was she doesn't want to come to the surface. But the owner, because we have to confirm the owner, it just doesn't move. If it doesn't move too long, then you can't breathe. Okay, we'll give a little water and then we feed with the water, with the pellets again, below the neck level, and give oil laxative and antibiotics. Today is day 3 of inpatient. We want to see whether the red ear slider is moving or swimming or not. So far you can see the appetite is there. Now normally they will swim towards the food if they're healthy. Eh? But you can see this one doesn't swim towards any food. It has appetite. It came in, the owner thinks that she is constipated. That means there's no stools pass out for many, many days or weeks. You can see there's a bit appetite, but turn towards the food. Then turn a bit, shift a bit towards the food. We are sunning her up so that she can have some sunlight. Sunlight has vitamin D to help in the development of the bone. See? She ate, if the palates are close enough, but she can't swim towards it. She's drinking water. There's one there, one palate eaten. Sort of see whether you put her closer or not. See whether she can walk towards it, swim. Push her closer towards one of the palates again. Which one to put? This side on the left, on this side. Or push her palate closer to her, either way. Okay. That might don't video first, just push her palate closer to her. Push her backwards a bit. Okay. It seems that she can't move much to eat her. Normally they can swim towards it if they are normal. Especially such an old one. So in this case, we are saved the trouble of having to syringe feed her, because she actually can eat. But if you don't put near, she can't eat, is it? That's why she lost a lot of weight and is considered emaciated. Probably use a spoon, your hand clean. That's not a spoon, where's the spoon? Don't use a hand. Put someone in first. Eh? 10, 20, then let her eat as much as she can. Very near to her. You see, these are fresh ones. Close the container to keep it fresh. I will have the video for you, you don't have the video. Just make sure that you eat how many, then you must count, Do you remember to count? Just count now, how many are there now? What happens is once they melted down, it's very hard to count. About 30, Okay, some scoop as near to her as possible so that she can finish eating. And that's good. Don't put your hand in, really. I don't need the hand clean or not. Just scoop nearer. Until it's all finished and we put someone in. That's how you count how many she eats. Now if she's constipated, she drinks water, it's good for her. Normally we put some oil in to less laxative. Come, take out your spoon, I'm videoing. Otherwise you're blocking me from videoing. No. Don't block me from videoing. Just scoop from the other side, that far end. So we haven't seen her walking, so she might have some problems internally. But appetite definitely is there, if you can put it close to her. And the things that you must have the patience to do it there, somehow. You count me already? Just now we give probably another 20. Just sweep it. Sweep it in front of her, that's good. Yeah, you see? I mean, although she's emaciated, means very thin, bone thin, no fat at all. But appetite is there, you see? Appetite is there. Just scoop the scoop it up and scoop it out. The thing is that you must have time to do all this. If you have no time, then the great year slider is so skinny, because if you have no time to put the food near to her, she can't eat. But at least today she's more active. It's day 3 already. We give antibiotics as well. Now the x-ray shows that the stomach is impacted with food. So she might have some trouble with the stomach earlier on. Owner says she eats 10 pellets a day. Of course, obviously, it's not enough. 10 pellets barely can survive. According to the owner, he based on the volume of the head. So he thinks 10 pellets is the same as the volume of the head. The volume of the head definitely is more than 10 pellets, as you can see. Although it's a guide, I suppose, with that. Finish it off first. Okay. Just let her be first. So get ready some more. Count 10 by 10, 20 by 20. Don't use your hand. Don't touch your hands again. Try to be clean. Don't use. And don't put back again. Don't put back. Estimate how many? 20? Okay. Obviously, don't put the spoon in front of her. She only eats from the water. She cannot eat directly from the spoon. Let's put in the water. Still very hungry, you can see that. So, once she can move, then she's able to shit. If she can shit and move, that means she has recovered. The cause could be some infection early on.
The terrapin remains constipated and is not eating. Stools are finally emerging from the terrapin, and it is on its way to recovery.